Shalom from Jerusalem. Shavuot is here. It's a wonderful celebration feast of Shavuot, Feast of Weeks, in New Testament known as Feast of Pentecost. Now, let's think about Days of Jesus. At the Shavuot, we've been talking in previous teachings, we were speaking, and every nation, all nation of Israel is speaking about sheaf, about dedication to the Lord, the first fruit of our fields, and we know fulfillment of that is Yeshua, who was resurrected, but also final harvest, harvest of souls. As we reap harvest from our fields, we're speaking about harvest of souls. Then from that grain, we do bread and dedicate bread to the Lord. We've been speaking about two breads because one symbolized people of Israel, another one symbolized Gentiles. God make us one, Jews and Gentiles together. And we've been talking about priests that he's dedicating these breads before the Lord. Wonderful symbols that become in fulfillment in the New Testament through Yeshua Jesus. So in this very moment, when all the nation focused on these practical things, they need to do everything God told them to do. They're speaking about harvest because fields are ready. Yeshua speaking about fulfillment. What is the real meaning of Shavuot, Feast of Weeks, that become a Pentecost? That's the harvest of souls, harvest in the earth, praise the Lord, but also harvest of souls, which is Katsir in Hebrew. That's the time of Katsir, but also it's a feast of Holy Spirit. And that day, when apostles gathered at the upper room right behind me, they were first in the Mount of Olives, then in the upper room praying and preparing for the feast, they knew something going to happen. And then in the morning, as we read in Acts chapter 2, Holy Spirit came as a rushing wind, and he changed their lives. He filled them with the presence and power of the Holy Spirit, and their life never been the same. So we're standing in Jerusalem today, and we're thinking of all this amazing event. And today, good news from the Lord, Holy Spirit is in you, Holy Spirit is in me, and together we're going to see his harvest done through us, because we work in the nations, we work here in Israel, in Jerusalem, fulfilling words of Yeshua. So the Feast of Harvest, Feast of Bread, this amazing feast become Feast of the Holy Spirit, celebration of victory of Jesus over death. So let's celebrate Feast of Shavuot, which is Pentecost, 50th day after the Passover. And let's remember, we have work to do. We have joy to receive from heaven and work to do. And in the final note, I want to share amazing revelation from the Bible, even in the midst of such an amazing feast, Feast of Blessings, Feast of Harvest, Feast of our giving in the nations to the Lord. God has also teaches people of Israel, when you're going to reap your harvest, and it says in Leviticus 23:22, when you reap the harvest of your land, you shall not wholly reap corners of your field. When you reap, you shall leave them for the poor and for a stranger. I am the Lord your God. He's also saying, remember, I am your God, I am your Lord. So I want you to take care of poor and needy. Leave the corners of your fields unreaped and leave it to poor and needy and strangers. So even in that amazing time when we celebrate salvation, God is also teaching us to think and pray for poor and needy. What a blessing, what a joy. That's the kingdom of God. It's taking care of our practical, carnal needs, but also taking care of our spiritual needs. So let's together walk the land in the power and presence and glory of the Holy Spirit. And let's pray for salvation, because Yeshua, he said, his word going to be preached in the nations, and then he's going to come back right here when we're standing, right here in Jerusalem for all the nations. So I pray that presence of the Holy Spirit will work in your life even stronger. I pray bracha, the spiritual blessing over your life, that Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit, will fill you with his power and then change your life and will use you for his glory. So, day of Shavuot, day of Pentecost, Shalom from Jerusalem.